Hey friends, welcome back to Bitfumes. I'm your host Sarthak and you can also call me Ankur. This is a channel where I talk about the Laravel and the cool thing about the Laravel. So if you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. Okay, so we have successfully created the multi-auth system. That means one section for the login of user and other section for the login of admin and totally different sections each and other. Okay, so now in this episode, we are going to set up the forgot password system. That means if I go to this forgot password, it will land me on the admin reset password because this is not configured. So it is on the user reset password. And if we type here my email address, that it will send me the link to reset my password. So firstly, set the reset password for the admin. So I will just log out from user. And now go to admin, and here when we hit the forgot password user, we expect admin reset password. So let's see how we will do that. For that, we will go to Sublime Text, close everything, go to this controllers inside HTTP, and inside controllers you will find admin folder which we have created in the last two episodes. So inside this, you can see there is a forgot password controller. Here you can see use send password reset email. If you are using Sublime Text, then it will show you the original path. But otherwise, you can go to vendor, Laravel, framework, source, illuminate, foundation, auth, send password reset. Go to this file and you can see this show link request form. Let's just copy this and overwrite in your admin forgot password controller. And obviously this is not the auth.password, it is admin.password.email. Now go and refresh and you can see it's admin reset password. Now we have successfully created this. Let's try to send an email. So we are sending email. In the other tab, I will open my Gmail account. So let's see what happened. It's taking time. And yep, you can see that we have emailed your password reset link. So let's see the email. So we have this email and now you can see this button. Let's just click this button. So I will click this button and it will land me on the reset password. But again, we does not want the reset password of user. We want the admin reset password. Okay. And for that, we have to go to this route called admin password slash reset slash token. But it will also showing us this form. So for that, we will go to the controller of reset password controller. And we will do the same thing as we have done in the forgot password controller. We will go to this file and copy from here and overwrite inside our reset password controller, and here give it a name of admin.password.reset. Now hit a refresh and you can see it will give you an error because we have not imported the request. So let's quickly go again and copy password and auth and request everything because we will use all this auth and password also. So let's just use everything again. So here it's good. Now click refresh and you can see admin password reset password. But you can see this is not the link given by our email. When we go to the email, it will give me only the password, not the admin password reset. Okay, so let's see how we will do this. And that means we will send the password reset email with the correct link inside this reset button. So for that, you will go to the forgot password controller and you can see when you go to this file, send password reset email, you can see there is a broker which is sending email. Okay, so it is send reset link. We will go to this file, password broker. And inside this file, you can see send password reset notification. Go to this. It will be inside can reset password. And you can see at the top, it is reset password. Go here. And now you can see this email has been sent by the Laravel. So it is taking the route of password.reset, not the admin.password.reset. So how we will do that? Obviously, this is a notification. So we will create new notification. For that, go to the command prompt and type php artisan make obviously notification. Notification name is admin reset password notification. And obviously you can name it anything you want, but I like that descriptive way of naming. So hit enter and you can see the notification has been created successfully. So where's that notification? It will be inside app folder. It is notifications. Go to this admin reset password notification. And you can see this is the notification created by our PHP command, but we want to give this message. So just copy this message from here, close this and go to this new notification we have created and paste it here. And instead of this, I will say admin.password.reset. Okay. And obviously I will say admin reset password. So inside the button, we will get admin reset password. Okay. So it's good. So we have successfully created, but inside this notification, you can see it will be getting the token. So we will give the token here. So I will give token and here I will say this slash this token is equal to token and it's good. So just close this and now what I want to do, I want to just override this send password notification to our admin controller. And here I am on the admin controller and I want to give this function here. And instead of this notification, I will send admin reset password notification, which is this. Okay. So it is getting the token and token we have given inside our notification. Let's see is that everything is correct or not. So go to our Laravel, click refresh. Otherwise, give me a CSRF token error. Bitfumes, hit enter. And now we will expect an email and yep, we get the email, but let's see, we have a problem. We does not get the required thing. So let's see what's the error. Okay, the problem is here when you go to the forgot password and no send password. Yep, here when we go to the forgot password, we will go to this send password reset email and at the bottom, just copy this broker from here and override this broker in your forgot password reset with a provider name. And obviously we know that for admin, the provider is admins. Okay. So this is completed. Okay. So let's go and try again. And it will give me the error because password admin password not found. So we have not imported again the problem. We have to import this. Let's import request also. Okay. So I think it's good. Let's see. Admin reset password notification is not imported. So obviously we have to go to the admin model and if we want to use apps slash notifications slash admin reset password notification. Okay, and now click reload and you can see it is loading. That means email is sending. So we are expecting an email. We get the email and now you can see it is admin reset password. So when I hit here, you can see it will land me on the correct page we want, we required. Okay. But here the next thing we are going to make changes is that when I go and let's say we are going to create the password, new password. So let's say password will be 123456. Instead of this, let's say 11111111111. Reset password, and you can see it is doing nothing. So let's try to log in with new password. So let's see what happened. 123456. No, 11111111. So hit enter, and you can see it will give me error. So let's try with old password, 123456. And yep, we are logged in. So where that resetting gone? So let's try to log in with the user with the password we have reset it. So 111111. So let's log in. And you can see actually the password resetted for the user, not for the admin. So we have to make changes in our reset password controller. So just close everything. Go to the HTTP controller, admins, and reset password controller. Here, obviously, we have shown the page, but we have to make other changes. So go to resetpassword.php. Okay, go at the bottom, and you can see there are two things, the guard and the broker. Copy these two, close, overwrite it inside your password reset controller, and obviously you have to give a provider name inside broker, so it will be admins, and the guard name inside the guard, so it will be only admin, not admins. So we have successfully made the changes here. Now go here and click refresh, send another email. So let's delete this email. Okay, close this. And we get the email. Let's see. Let's go to the password reset link. Reset the password 22222222. Reset password. And yep, we are on the admin page. Let's see is that everything is correct or not, because we are on the admin homepage. That means I think everything has correct. So let's log out and go to the route of admin. Go here and password will be 222222. Hit enter, and yep, the password is successfully reset. So you can see we have successfully created the multi-auth system. We have successfully created the password reset system for admin. So in the next episode, I'm going to show you how you can log in with a different role of the admin. That means one admin user has the role of admin, one admin user has the role of editor, one admin user has the role of let's say publisher. So for each and every user, we want to redirect to other page. That means to of obviously a home page of every other role of user. So we will meet in the next episode. If you have doubt in this episode, if you stuck on any step, then you please feel free to comment me. I will always ready to respond. And if you have any doubt in your project, feel free to comment me. You can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can also message me there. And share this video with your developer friend. And don't forget to subscribe. That is the most important thing. Don't forget to subscribe. We'll meet in the next episode. Till then, be happy. Goodbye.